Hi everybody. What a day at the desk of J7409. Man, these storms are blowing up, people. Big changes here. Big changes here, okay? Now, first of all, when we get up here, this is very important for everyone on the North Carolina and South Carolina coast. This thing may not hit anybody directly, then again, it may, and then again, we just might get some of the outskirts of it. But it slowed up so much, the expected system that was supposed to push it on out, apparently they're going to miss each other a little bit. We'll have to wait and see. Maybe it'll move on out, maybe it won't, but this is what it's looking like now. Showers and thunderstorms are increasing in association with a well-defined low-pressure system located a few hundred miles southeast of North Carolina's coast. Environmental conditions are expected to be conducive for additional development of this system, and a tropical depression is likely to form over the next couple of days while the system moves slowly northwestward and stalls. That's the key. Oh, it's just going to stall and kind of meander around a little bit near the North Carolina coast over the weekend. Now, interest along the North Carolina and South Carolina coast should monitor the progress of this system during the next several days. Okay? Now, if any of you guys look on the GFS map, it has the thing turning into maybe a Category 1 hurricane. If you look on the European model, it has it not developing into a hurricane, but into a low system. And that may all change in the next 5 minutes. I don't know. These things are popping up so fast and intensifying so fast, it's very, very hard right now. I'm doing the best I can to try to keep you informed. So, as this goes, everybody on the North Carolina and South Carolina coast right here, please be aware and keep up with this. It has a 70% chance of forming in 2 days and an 80% in 5 days, and it's right here, okay? Now, for Beryl, this is another thing. Everybody pay attention. It's not going to die down like we thought it was, okay? Now, right now, it's a Category 1. The winds are 80 miles per hour. The minimum central pressure is 994 millibars. Tracking at 10.7 north, 46.5 west. It's moving. It's slowed down just a tad. It's moving west at 15 miles per hour. What has changed? Well, it's going to be a hurricane when it goes over the islands. And it's still going to be a tropical storm going over part of the areas right up in here. Hold on, we'll check it all out. Okay, as you can see right now, here we go. X marks a spot, it's Category 1. And hurricane, 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 okay? It's looking like it's still probably going to be a hurricane when it goes over the islands and then turn into a tropical storm. This is a little ways out here, still tropical when it goes over the southern part of the Dominican Republic. So all you guys on the islands, I've been telling you, I know you got everything ready. Just keep it that way. Who knows what I'm going to show you next? I'm just being real honest from my heart. This stuff is changing so fast, it's very, very hard to keep up with it. Now, I'll give you that Beryl is a very teeny tiny storm so far as the width and the area that it covers. It's only like 40, 50 miles wide, okay? But wherever it goes with hurricane strength, you're going to know it, okay? And I said it looked really strange. Well, it did. I've done some research, and there was another storm, another hurricane called Danny years ago. Okay, it was a little storm just like Beryl that turned into the hurricane. Okay, so it's not the first time a storm this size has turned into a hurricane. But I want everybody to look at this map really good and be aware. See, this is a picture of it, or a graph rather, of how big it is. See, it's not that big of a storm. But if you happen to get hit by the north side of this storm, that's where the winds are the strongest. If this north side comes around and hits you, that's where the winds are strongest. Okay, there are still no watches and coastal watches and warnings in effect for the guys, but everybody in the Lesser Antilles should monitor the progress of Beryl, as hurricane watches could be needed for some of the islands by tonight. More than likely, you're going to get hurricane warnings and watches by tonight for some of the islands. Okay? Now, Beryl is moving toward the west, and a faster westward to west-northwestward motion is expected to begin over the weekend and continue through early next week. And on the forecast track, the center of Beryl will approach the Lesser Antilles over the weekend and cross the island chain late Sunday or Monday. Now, the maximum sustained winds right now have increased to around 80 miles per hour. And of course, there are much higher gusts, and additional strengthening is forecast during the next couple of days. And Beryl is expected to still be a hurricane when it reaches the Lesser Antilles. I can't stress this enough. I want to highlight it right here. Beryl is expected to still be a hurricane when it reaches the Lesser Antilles late Sunday or Monday. Now, weakening is expected once Beryl reaches the Eastern Caribbean Sea at some point Monday, but the system may not degenerate into an open trough as it was expected at that time. It's not going to do that until it reaches the vicinity of Hispaniola and the Central Caribbean Sea. And this is something that all you guys need to really take note of, is your barometric pressure. It's 994 millibars, which equals out to 29.36 inches if you have a regular barometer in your house. Most of them are set to read this. The lower this gets, the closer the storm will be to you. When it starts to rise, give it at least an hour of rising, then the storm itself should be past you. I'm not going to read all this to you. Just take my word for it. It's going to keep intensifying, as you can see, 100 mile per hour winds in 36 hours, 48 hours, 70 mile per hour at 72 hours. It's not going to be any lower to 45, still a tropical storm in 96 hours, and it's going to start to dissipate into that trough area within 120 hours. That's how long it's going to take. So be aware, it's going to keep strengthening. My TCVN model usually is right, and most of the time it has been now, and it's keeping up track well. This isn't just the models from the National Hurricane Center. I haven't put the other models on yet, but as you can see, it's going to be a tropical storm over here at Haiti, okay? Going across portions of Haiti right here, it's still going to be a tropical storm with winds of 45 miles per hour. Okay, you can handle that, but I hate that you have to have it. But for everybody up and down the island chain, you're going to get hit with a hurricane more than likely. So please be aware of that. We'll turn the models on real quick here for you. Come on, come on, come on. I've tried to make this a little bigger for you. See, it's still a hurricane right here. It's going to go over Dominica. Right in this area, as it showed all along, and as I've said, this is what it's looking like. Of course, it could go anywhere where you see this cone of uncertainty. So, you know, St. Lucie, all of these Guadeloupe, all of these places. I mean, everybody's going to feel it to some degree, but you have to remember again, it's a tiny storm. But if you happen to get the effects from the north side of it, you're going to get the full brunt of it. Now, as we move along, when we get up to this area, we have tropical storms all the way up here showing in Haiti again, still tropical storm, and it does not start to change until what most of the models are reading and combined are saying as it comes off and gets into the Caribbean Sea and right up in this area, right below Cuba. So with all of that said and done, everybody, be aware on the North and South Carolina coast. I don't know what's going to come of that. We've got to wait and see. I'll keep you abreast soon as something comes out and I can find anything at all about it to update you with. And everybody down on the islands, please, please prepare and be safe. Please subscribe, share this information with your family, with your friends. If you have anyone in these areas, please make sure that they know what's going on. I mean, it's so hard. You know, I kind of feel for the people on TV given the weather. They might say one thing, and as soon as they say it and the broadcast is over, it might be something different. So that's what's happening with me right now. It's like it's all I can do is to keep up. So, and I'll give you something else. On top of it all, there is another system coming off the coast of Africa. We got to stay on top of it, people. These things are just coming in now. So, with all that said and done, everybody, please be safe. Please share this information in this video, and please subscribe to my channel. Please click subscribe, click the bell to make sure you get all of the latest weather news, information, watches, warnings, and tropical news. Thank you so much, each of you. Much peace, love, and kindness.